Good evening, everyone. As you know, I'm Omung Kumar, and here to talk something what happened in my life and about movies, cinema, art direction, and whatnot. You see, let's go behind the scenes, okay? Behind the scenes with me, something which we've not done before. I mean, you all haven't done before. You see, Albert Einstein said, logic can take you from A to B, but imagination can take you everywhere. You know, you can go crazy. When we were born with the wildest of imagination. We could imagine anything on earth and we could do it. We could imagine and create a full war scene with a simple G.I. Joe figurine. Or imagine the most romantic scene with just two Barbie dolls. So why is that when we grow up, we lose it? You know, logic comes in our mind and we don't live to our potential. You know, when I was 8 years old, and in my terrace, in my home earlier, I used to go up on my terrace and paint giant superheroes with colored chalk, paint painstakingly for hours and hours and hours. And it was fun for me. I was living my imagination. But one fine day, one pessimistic type of a neighbor came up and said, superheroes are not real, man. Do something real, Baba. You should do something which is worthwhile, meaningful. I started to cry. I said, if this is life, then how can I? I went home that night. My mother, who's a theater personality, told me something very important, which I still live by. She said, nothing is real or not real. Everything that you can imagine, you can turn into reality. Well, someone imagined a great wall, you know, which would divide an entire nation, and that became the Great Wall of China. Someone imagined that we could lift ourselves from Earth, go up into space, and we did it. You see, that neighbor changed my thinking. I said, I have to do something different. When I was 10, I started doing my own comic books, you know, illustrating and living a different world with subtext and everything. I was having fun till I grew up. My college, I went into a commercial art. I took up commercial art, you know. Out of college, went straight into advertising. And, you know, I still remember getting up on Saturday morning and opening newspaper, colored newspaper. That was that time, Saturday Times was very famous. Open and see your ad getting published. Hello, they pay me for this. My ideas from, I mean, it was amazing. I was living my dream at that time. I did lots of TV commercial, acted in a lot of them, modeled a lot. Until in 1992, ZTV came. ZTV came and changed everybody's life. And a game show called Ek Minute changed my life. Okay, I started to host that. The director, Tarun Chopra, told me, you're a designer. Why don't you design the set for this? Well, from small comic books to half-page ads, now my work would jump out of paper and go onto the walls, and voila, I have a fabulous set. And there was no looking back. That was my first set design. But after that, after this, I did numerals and numbers of, you know, different stage and reality shows. This is Big Boss right now, okay? So you name it. We were having fun, from talent shows to music shows to cookery shows to dance shows to singing shows, TED Talk show, this one which happened just now for Shah Rukh. So this also we did, lots and lots of things, enjoying yourself. Historical shows, Mahabharat, you know, and Prithvi Raj. But you see, my life was getting bigger and bigger and bigger. I wanted more. Says, okay, let's design stage shows. IFA Awards, Z Awards, you know, again, more Z Awards, Screen Awards, Stardust Awards, Filmfare, you name it, and we did it. So these are few of our work. It's not much. It's a 25-year-old journey, so there's quite a lot. But you see, I wanted a little more. So I got an opportunity. Viscraft gave me a place in Delhi, Gurgaon, called Kingdom of Dreams. Okay? This was a crazy place. India under one lane. What to do? Anything that you want, do. please yourself. So I was the art director, and my wife, Vanita, was the production designer. Okay, that was a sketch, this is the real place, and there's a huge lane inside. India's so colorful. How do I put it in one lane? So, okay, desired in such a way that this is Lucknow. From Kashmir to Kanyakumari, everything is in there. With cafeterias, with, you know, puppets, huge puppets. This is from the sketch to reality, okay? That sky is a fake sky. Okay, when you come inside, you go crazy. Madhya Pradesh, this is a completely fake sky. We completed this in 1 year, okay? It's a crazy, trippy land. But you know what the best thing is? The best thing is, when we completed this, me, my wife, and the organizers were just sitting in the cafeteria, waiting for the doors to open. The moment the doors opened, and we got in the visitors, the smile on their face is the most happiest thing that we can see. I got an opportunity for the opening ceremony of Commonwealth, okay? In an open ground, how do I make a set? Let's make the biggest of aerostat. That aerostat is a complexity on its own. Okay, make it rise. And from there, the puppets would come up, or a huge tree would come up from the ground, or Buddha would rise, or Gandhiji would come up. Well, it was endless. But you see, wanted more. You know, I wanted to create different worlds. I wanted to create world in such a way that I could place people in it. What to do? Movies. Can you tell me, how many of y'all over here, raise your hand by if you watched films. You watched films? Everybody's watching. Oh my God, my job is easy. How many of y'all know three art directors' name from the movies you've watched? Oh, my job has become hard. No one? You know, oh, okay. You know what an art director does in a film? No. Let me educate. Well, you read books. Everybody's read book, right? When you read a book, you create your own world. Every word can be interpreted differently by different people. You're reading the same book, but you're visualizing differently. He's different, visualizing differently. So you see, an art director's job is to actually create a world where the director can put his story in. You know, that's a very, very simple thing. And everything that you can imagine, you can make it real. Imagination, with my imagination, it's in my head. I make it my toolkit. I visualize it, I sketch it, and I put it on top of the walls and in properties. I let the director's vision forward. Let's do an exercise, okay? Everyone, just close your eyes for a minute, just please, and imagine what I'm gonna tell you, okay? Don't open your eyes, okay? The same scene, a boy is waiting for his long-lost lover under a starry night near a cafe where they first met. The surrounding, a cityscape. It's raining, shh, okay? It's in Antarctica. All the hoardings that you see around are made of colored dots. It's 150 years from now. Our hero, heroine, our protagonists, our humans, rest everyone over there are giants. Well, okay, you can open your eyes right now. Notice how, you know, words, when manipulated, can mean something else only. And I believe, and I can bet that everyone over here started with a clear vision, but finally ended up in a completely muddled up place. It's like, but you did create your own world. You know, that's what an art director does. You know, he takes the director's vision and gives him what he wants. But for us, we give him more. Let him come to our place. You know, let him visualize what we do. So he visualizes, we give life to it, and the cinematographer gives light to it. Like, for example, when Mr. Sanjay Leela Bhansali was doing Black, okay, we read the story. It's a story of a female who is blind, deaf, and mute. Now, okay, how do we create a house for that? It's in Shimla. Are there black walls? We thought, let's do black walls. I had designed so many sets, but I didn't know whether, are there black walls in a house? Did some research. Yes, people do have black walls. Okay, let's create black walls. But then, because she's blind, we're doing black walls. Can we do something else? Can't we have light source coming in? the cinematographer, Mr. Ravi Chandran, he's a fantastic guy. He gave life and light to my set. You know, we said, okay, let's not have normal windows, let's have huge windows, and let's have the whole movie will dedicate it with lights. So this is what happened. Just magic was created just by six, you know, windows. I would give him opportunity and he would change it to a completely different thing. Give him 200 lamps which are in a room, and suddenly magic happens. So how do I basically imagine a scene? Okay, I basically go into four different questions that I ask. First question, well, is style of the film. What is the style that I'm looking at? While reading, is it a mythological set? Is it, you know, these are a simple set, a real set, or rich, classy, crazy, cluttered, a bedroom which is unbelievable, or a stylized film, you know, futuristic film, or a mystical imaginary world of your own. So we can do lots when we read and understand what the concept and style of the film is. So these are all different films that we're going to. The second question that I ask myself is the color. What is the color of the film? Basically, color plays a very subconsciously on your mind. You know, when you watch anything, colors are very important. It plays with your mood when you see colors and the way you visualize, and you know, you'll react to the scene in that way. If it's too dark, your mindset will go like that. If it's too bright, you'll open up and see like that. So it plays on your mind. And color also is important for the costume designer for the film, which is like, if suppose I've made a black. Now black is, everything is black in the sense, does the costume guy want the character to stand out or blend in? Like in black, she created everything which the characters also is muted. You know, just with light source we can see the film. Or same Rani Mukherjee in Saawariya, character was flamboyant, wanted to stand out, so blue color comes in. You know, muted background, but she stands out. Or same Rani Mukherjee, black, again in black, where the room changed, and in the end, the black sets became white. The teacher became student, and the student became teacher. So see over here, Rani stood out in black, and Amit ji went back in white. And that's how we play with colors. You know? The fourth question, real or fantasy? It's a very crazy world. You know, we can go over the top and create fantasy world in reality. Like again, Saawariya, if you see, it's based in India, but we don't know where. Okay, so it's a fantasy world that we have created. It's like huge Buddha statues, lotuses, gondolas. It's crazy, but it's real. You know, a huge tree in the middle of a room. Now, on the other hand, the real thing is, this is a Sarabjit's picture. Okay, this picture, if you see, is very important in all the aspects, because the script was telling a story of 23 years, the actor was telling a story of 23 years, the costume was telling a story of 23 years, and the sets were talking 23 years. How? The mood would be colorful, so I've designed the set. Nice, okay, it's a Punjabi house, but the role of the production designer, which is my wife, Vanita, she had the most toughest thing. How? When the sets are happy, the colors are happy, the people are glowing, everybody is young, everything is in place, there are these two buffaloes, there's everything over there. Kate is doing well. Suddenly a disaster happens. Costume changes. People started aging. The buffaloes are sold. The background walls get lessened. Objects are removed. More disaster happens. Then what? Suddenly white hair, muted colors, and a bare wall. In the end, when just the last remains of Sarabjit comes in, there's nothing in the house but except just leaves, dry leaves flying away. The fourth most important story is, I mean, when I think of reading a script, is the budget, which somebody will say that's the most important thing. Yes and no, okay? Budgets are important, but not so much. If the bigger the movie, the bigger the budget, but still there is a budget. If it's like a 20 sets, I have budget only for 15. How do I stretch that? Cunningly, imagining it. Imagining a thing that you five sets are something that is not there. How do I stretch it? I stretch it like this. Like in this particular set, the platform, if you see, the side platform, we've raised it to 1 foot. Okay, why? Nobody asked the question. And in fact, the doors and windows, everything was raised to 1 foot. Why? Because after they finish shooting over here, when they come back, the same height that I've increased, we put in water inside. Nobody came to know, and we doubled the set. You know, very smartly, very beautifully, because we couldn't begin. So we came up. We finished our film, and we wanted one more set. We wanted to stretch it a little more. Okay, it was raining, we couldn't get studios. We got a studio in Mira Road, somewhere far away, and we didn't have flooring, we didn't have any set. No time to make a set. Now what to do? Okay, think. Okay, I asked my choreographer, if I put sand on the floor, will it be okay for you to dance? Saying, hello, it'll enhance my choreography. Good. Got loads and loads of sacks and sacks of gunning bags filled with sand. Just spread it out. Now what do we do for walls? Okay, the gunning bag is there. Cut the gunning bag open, stitch it together, put it on the walls, drape it around, okay? But still it's not looking good. Okay, let's paint khajurao, Kama Sutra on the walls. Make pillars only of cloth, and voila, we got a fantastic set, which happened as trippy. So this is a set that was done in just 2 days. And suddenly we created magic. Well, too much said, let's expand your imagination. Our producer has given us a canvas. Okay, I want everyone over here to become directors. Okay, let's create and make a set on the spot right now. Give me a style, any style. Rich, classy, futuristic, mythological. Sir? Futuristic. Oh, you live in the future. Okay, futuristic. Okay, ye girne wala hai. Future. Okay. Indoor, outdoor. Bahar rehte hain sab log. Okay. What does a hero do? Okay, scientist. What is the weather? Is it raining? Is it sunny? Is it snowing? Snowing. Dreamland. Okay. Snow. Theek hai bhai, let's go for it. Okay, it's outdoor. So, someone's come from the future. This is ICT Mumbai guy, chemical giving to Mr. Alien who's just come down, and whatever, it's in the Alps. There could be done lots more. But yes, if you see, this is one scene. And if it's seen, a picture can speak 1,000 words. Imagine you have 2 hours, 29 minutes more to go in a film. What all you can do, lots of things. So, the next time, when you all go to a dark theater, the next 2.5 that you're going to live in, you're actually living in art director's world. You know, an unbelievable world. So, imagination is the key thing. Imagination is real. I live my imagination. Imagination is tangible. Okay? Next time, go home, destroy something, change something in your house, your bathroom, your college, just paint some wall, create something, imagine something crazy. Or, you see, lots can be done with imagination. But if you can't do anything, just become kids again, you know, and live your imagination. Thank you.